Hello everybody, thank you for joining us this fine day. Today we'll be doing a quick sketch of a person in a cloak. So basically we're just checking out how that cloak looks on any particular person. So I'm going to draw, let's actually start with the person. I was going to go on to the cloak, so I think that's not the ideal method. So right there, shoulders, heart, head, right around there. Right, I'm showing it at a perspective at an angle. And so arms, chest will be somewhere here. Torso, let's use that arm for the rest of the body. I don't think I need to put in the entirety of the legs there, so I'll just stop there somewhere. And then quickly put down object onto the paper far more quickly. Face there so that we have something to work with in terms of putting out the cloak. Right, so that's something going there. Put down a person. So now you're just going to put down cloak for the person. And I think that I'm going to go this way. And the idea is that you have to imagine that it's like just wrapped around him, and let's say that he's also wearing some kind of coat, the coat and cloak, like, you know, they go together in most popular media. So it's low over his head right there, and the hood going, and the hood will have, of course, some sort of pull lines going downward, because it's so hard, and it's like flopping down, it's not stiff. So if it's flopping down, yes, you'll have to put in more shadows toward the bottom here and have the creases highlighted sort of like that way. In this case we have shadows also, so now the shadow falls right under according to the top here. It also falls here on this end. But again, so I'm imagining that it's, let's say there's like draped around him, and depends on how fine the material he's wearing, how stiff it is, you'll put in some sort of tones to make it like work. But so we'll focus on this area here. So the material right around his shoulder, and then now drooping down, and all the lines will come down like that, starting here, because it's flatter around his shoulders where it's like lying down. Let me take some of those lines out actually before I change my entire perspective there. So we'll take those stray lines out as well. You'll see in a moment that we'll have a cloak that actually works for us. Okay, so the cloak, essentially, depending on how much of it is, let's say that it's going down that way, and then straighter lines, some of it ending this way, I guess for style, and then even around here, you can show like, you know, it gathering down, or some lines going like that, depending on what kind of fold you're looking to show in what place. I'm going to do the blacks like later, so right here again. So some lines here, I've just put that in. Some lines here. Okay, so when we are putting in the shadows, of course, you will go according to the straight like work something along each fold. This was not essentially part of our exercise. I'm just putting something down so that the shadows pass right along those lines, depending on how raised the cloak is. Minimal or more in other areas, it all depends. Let's give this guy some slacks. Let's all remember though that this is essentially a quick sketch, and I keep straying a little bit from the objective in that I was not supposed to focus on the figure, but maybe perhaps I'm doing it because it just shows that how the details look when they're converging, in the sense of the attire, in the sense of, so okay, I think I got things going there, and you'll see that I'm going to now use a slightly heavier pencil here. Cast all those darker tones where I need them. The idea of doing cape in this pop culture media, let's say, is to have the routine shadows going for it, but also to use those tones and then entire get up to your advantage to fit that media. Now if this was done for an entirely different purpose, for example if we were doing some fine art with a folded up cloth being reflected, we would take much more time going to each and every crease and work out the details in a much more intricate, much more sophisticated manner, because folded cloth doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to be just like, you know, straight objects. It's rounder curves, sharper curves, but that is the idea of putting together a cloak or a cape, but that is not a flying cape, so it's a, let's say it's a drooping cape, falling cape, and that is actually, in case you're wondering, that would be the character of the Spectre. I just got that in my head when I was let's say a quarter of a way through, but that is the idea of casting the tones and the shadows when you're trying to do a cape for this media. Thank you very much for watching. Please do subscribe, keep in touch, have yourself a wonderful day.